Hello creators, you're watching the VSDC channel. In today's tutorial, we will show you how to create a beautiful countdown timer for fitness videos for free. This timer will include a 60-second countdown with a 60-second pause, along with a workout progress bar. Now, without further ado, let's get started. To begin, create a project and set it to Full HD definition with a frame rate of 30 frames per second, or by modifying the settings of an already opened project in the Properties window. Great! In the project currently displayed on the screen, you can see the final result and the structure that we will build from scratch today. Let's start with the 60-second countdown timer. It will consist of 4 sprites, each responsible for different countdown effects. Create the first sprite in your project, matching the scene size, and adjust its settings as follows. Uses container? No. Show effects? Yes. Brush? Transparent. Note that we will apply the same settings to all the sprites that we create today. After creating the sprite, let's rename it to Counter and Circle. It is important to set its duration to 1 minute, so the countdown starts from 60 seconds and goes down to 0 seconds. Next, double-click to open the sprite and create the countdown timer. You can find it in the Objects tool panel under the drop-down menu for the text tool. Add it to the scene, stretch it to match the sprite size, set the font size to 300, and align it both vertically and horizontally. Now, let's move on to the settings. We are interested in the counting direction, so set the plane backwards parameter to true. Additionally, we want to ensure that the timer exclusively displays seconds. To achieve this, simply input %s in the pattern field. This adjustment will make the countdown progress from 60 seconds all the way down to 0. The next step is to add a shadow effect, which should be placed inside the countdown timer, and its settings should match the visual guidance displayed on the screen. Let's get back to the counter and circle sprite. Our goal is to create a circle around the counter, and we will achieve this by using a pre-made template from the Free Shape tool. Set the duration to 1 minute, but keep in mind that we will only need the outline with the ability to animate it. To start, use the Curve Line tool to create a single point. Next, double-click the free shape to copy all the points from it. Go back to the Curve Line, double-click it, and paste the copied points. Once you've done that, feel free to delete the free shape since it's no longer needed. Now, let's adjust the line thickness to 20 pixels and animate the visible length from 0 to 100. Your animation is now complete. In our example, we use the point gradient to fill the segments of the curve with different colors. To achieve this effect, change the fill to point gradient and navigate inside the curve. Select all the points and in the Properties menu, choose Add Pen Gradient Settings. Here we are going to assign different colors to each point. For the top point, let's make it blue. For the right point, violet. For the bottom point, red. And for the left point, orange. Users with the Pro version of VSDC can also change colors over time by adding keyframes for each frame. However, for the free version, you can only choose 2 colors, the first and the last. Let's take a look at the result. It looks great. The circle gradually gets drawn, smoothly changing its color. Now let's tackle the task of making the numbers in the counter change color to match the circle. To get started, double-click on the counter to open it. Create a rectangle using the free shape template and make sure the rectangle is larger than the counter. Then adjust the duration of the rectangle on the timeline, ensuring it covers the period until the circle's line touches the right point. Now, go to the settings and choose Point Gradient in the brush field. Double-click on the rectangle to enter its properties. Select all the points and in the Properties window, choose Brush Gradient Settings. Next, select one point in the rectangle and open the Color Editor. Set the initial color to blue and the final color to violet. Now, let's apply this color to the other points. Select all the points on the timeline and in the Properties window, right-click the Synchronization button and choose the point from the drop-down list where you previously changed the color. Done. Now the entire free shape changes its color from blue to violet. To continue coloring the numbers in the counter, create a copy of the free shape and shift its start to the end of the previous one. In this new shape, you will need to set the color values from violet to red. Then create two more copies with color transitions from red to orange, and one with the transition from orange to blue. And there you have it. Now, all that's left is to set the blending mode of all the free shapes to source in, and the counter numbers will automatically be colored according to the free shapes. Next, we'll create the effect of thin lines that appear when the circle's line reaches them, and these lines should also have the same color as the circle. Return to the main timeline tab, Scene 0, and create a sprite that covers the entire scene. Adjust its settings to match the other sprites and name it Line. Now, go back to the counter and circle sprite and copy the curve line that we used to create the circle. Paste it inside the line sprite. Then apply the distort effect, placing it above the curve line, but not inside it. Choose the Z-drop type for this effect and configure it as illustrated on the screen. This will create a cool effect as if the lines were drawn by a brush. However, we need to orient these lines towards the center. To achieve this, double-click inside the curve line to enter its properties and add another distort effect, this time selecting the faceted glass type with settings as illustrated on the screen. To complete the effect, we'll make some final adjustments by reducing the radius of the circle using a zoom effect. Here's how to do it. Inside the line sprite, add a zoom effect below the distort layer. Set the zoom effect to reduce the radius by 90%. Additionally, decrease the line thickness of this curve line to 3 pixels to make it thinner. Add a lens flare effect at the same level as the Z-drop distort effect to slightly modify the gradient color of the lines. Set the center of the lens flare effect to the center of the circle and adjust the settings as needed. Go back to the main timeline tab, Scene 0, and adjust the transparency of the line sprite to 50% to make sure that these lines don't distract from the main animation. The next step is to add white lines around the perimeter of the circle. These lines should have a thickness slightly larger than the size of the circle and should be drawn simultaneously with the circle. Instead of using a mask, we will use a different method – stretching text along a curve. Create another sprite on Scene 0 tab and name it White Line. Double-click to open the sprite and type 8 uppercase letters I. These letters will serve as the lines. Now, go back to the counter and circle sprite and copy the circle from there. Paste one copy onto the Scene 0 tab and insert the second copy into the white line sprite. The copy on the Scene 0 tab will be used as a trajectory for the text, while the one in the white line sprite will serve as a mask for drawing. Name the curve in the Scene 0 tab as Path and the one in the white line sprite as mask. Select the path curve and remove its drawing animation by setting the visible length in the properties window to 100%. To make the line transparent, choose path mode for the pen field. Now, let's proceed with the text. In the text settings, find the binding to path field and select the path curve. Almost there, you just need to adjust the font size to 22. Next, let's configure the mask curve. Choose the source in blending mode for it. To ensure that the lines extend beyond the circle's radius, set the fill thickness to 28 pixels. But that's not all. There is one more sprite left to create, which will color the end of the circle as if it's drawn. Return to scene 0 and create another sprite that covers the entire scene. Name it Flame. Now, go back to the counter and circle sprite, copy the circle from there and paste it into the flame sprite. Change the fill type to gradient. Open the gradient editor and make the opacity change gradually from 100 to 0 while changing the fill color from yellow to red. It looks great. But at the end of drawing the circle, you might want the circle to finish with the same blue color it started with. To achieve this, add the custom transparency effect inside the flame sprite. Set the transparency parameter from 100 to 0 and place this effect at the end of the animation. To wrap up, let's merge the created sprites on the Scene 0 tab to make it easier to transfer the created character to other projects. To do this, select all the sprites you've created on the Scene 0 tab. Combine them into one sprite and name it Main Counter. Adjust its settings and the counter will be ready. Now, let's move on to creating a 30-second timer. Duplicate the Main Counter sprite and name it Rest. Place it up to the main counter sprite and set its duration to 30 seconds. To ensure that the circle is fully drawn in 30 seconds, enter the rest sprite and change the duration of all objects to 30 seconds. Turn off the layer responsible for flame in the previous sprite, as well as the line sprite. You should have two sprites with counters and text, along with one layer for the text. Enter the sprite with the counter. Hide the curved line responsible for the circle around the numbers and disable the visibility of the free shape layers responsible for coloring the text. Now the text is white. Finally, enter the sprite with the text and change its content. Instead of 8 eyes, type 8 slashes. Now everything is ready. Finally, let's proceed with creating the fill-in line. To do this, follow these steps. Create a new scene in the Project Explorer window. Within this new scene, create a rectangle and position it in the center of the scene. Adjust its duration to 60 seconds, just like the first counter. Next, change the rectangle settings by setting the round size field to 80-80. This will round the corners of the rectangle. Make the field transparent, increase the outline to 5 pixels, and change its color to white. Create a copy of the rectangle, place it on a layer below, and name it Mask. Enter the mask rectangle by double-clicking it and create a curved line from one edge of the rectangle to the other. Change the line thickness to 200 pixels and create an animation for the visible length from 0% to 100%. Great, let's continue. Change the fill-in type of the rectangle to point gradient. Enter the curve within the rectangle, select the points, and in the properties window, choose pen gradient settings for both points. Set the left point to violet and the right point to red. Return to the Timeline tab with the curve, the Source in Blending mode for it. Change the brush settings to Solid. Now, your line will fill up over 60 seconds. Next, let's move back to Scene 0 and create copies of the two rectangles. Adjust their duration to 30 seconds. Also, change the filling type to Solid and set the fill color to white. Enter the fill in rectangle and change the duration of the curve line to 30 seconds. And it's all set! Great job! To use this counter in your videos, we recommend exporting it with a transparent background. Here's how to do it. In the project settings, set the background transparency level to 0. Go to the Export tab. Choose the device type as PC and the format as MOV. Access Profile settings and select the PNG lossless video codec. Set the quality to 100%. Make sure to enable the option to split scenes into separate files during export. To do this, uncheck the Join Scenes to Single option in the additional settings at the bottom of the export window. Export the video. After it's done, you can overlay it into your videos, position it wherever needed, and scale it as desired. Thank you for watching! Please let us know what you think about this tutorial in the comments and stay tuned for our next videos. See you next time!